From Ossenango, New York, let's bring in Don DeBar, activist and commentator. Good to have you with us, Don. So let's listen to your comments regarding this latest thing that's now on the spotlight, thieving and looting Palestinian money and property.
Well, yeah, now this is 100 days, I guess, since the beginning of this particular battle and this war going on since at least 1948. And it happened, you know, we're talking today on the Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. holiday here in the United States. And some of the words that they're not mentioning in the various celebrations of Dr. King's life around the United States, but that he himself mentioned very strongly and front and center. Particular, I'll read this from his speech a year to the day before he was murdered. He spoke at Riverside Church in New York City and said, "What about Vietnam?" He was talking about some youths that had asked him about things going on in the world, and he was saying why nonviolence was the way to, you know, get their grievances aired. He said, "They ask if our own nation wasn't using serious doses, serious massive doses of violence to solve its problems, to bring about the changes it wanted. Their questions hit home," he said, "and I knew I could never again raise my voice against the violence of the oppressed in the ghettos without having first spoken clearly to the greatest purveyor of violence in the world today, my own government." Now, that particular year, 1967, okay, is 58 years ago now, or 57 years ago. Mm-hmm. We have spent almost $1 trillion in today's dollars each year on war making. Making the, you know, the greatest purveyor of violence in the world in 1967 look like the little 10-year-old bully kid up on the corner. The situation on the ground in Israel reflects exactly the situation he was talking about. He spoke about the peasants in Vietnam who wanted nothing more than to be left alone and to be free, and who were willing to fight for their freedom against the largest military on the planet. If you look at what is going on the ground in that region, then you see that you had 1,100 people killed October 7th by a variety of folks and under very suspicious conditions, such as sitting illegally on occupied land, murdered instead 25, or I don't even know what the number is today, civilians in Gaza, mm-hmm. 10 or 15,000 children now, whatever it is, with weaponry that at the ICJ last Thursday we found included 200 2-megaton bombs dropped on Gaza, which is the size of Manhattan and a population about the same as Manhattan's. 200 2-megaton bombs is about 10 times the 40 megatons combined dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Right. That's what has been dropped. That doesn't count all the other bombs. That's the 2,000-pound bombs that they've dropped 200 of on the people of Gaza. So I don't know how else to contextualize it except to look at it in terms of the array of massive military power being dumped on civilians in the same context that we look at what the U.S. did in Vietnam, and I could go down the list, look at Iraq, look at all of the graveyards basically that were first excavated by the United States and filled with corpses from one end of the world to the other. And this is exactly that. Again, the most horrific incident of it that we've seen yet. And the world has to answer this.